because it went from crying to this, oh, why am I getting freaked out? Like, I don't get freaked out. Welcome back to Pretty Mean Part 1. Yes, if you haven't been keeping up with Pretty Mean so far, yes, I am having 2 Pretty Means this year. One in September and 1 in October, but the only difference is I'm not uploading every single day in September, but I am uploading every single day in October. And this month's theme for September is It, Chapter 2, Pennywise. I'm back in Pennywise's lair. Definitely check out my last videos for Pretty Mean. I'm so excited, guys. I love Pennywise's lair. Like, I want this to be a permanent set. So, for today's video, I thought that we would take a stroll down memory lane, but not really, but like kind of, if that makes any sense. You guys know back in the day when I was like all about shadow people, the hat man. I mean, I'm still all about shadow people and the hat man. I've personally have never had an experience with shadow people. Now, I've seen 2 shadows before, one at Eastern State Penitentiary in cell block 14, and one when I was like 8 or 9 years old, and it chased me down a hill. But those shadow people weren't the shadow people that a lot of people claim to see when they're sleeping during sleep paralysis, and there's these shadow people just in the corners of the room staring at you. Like, I was chased by a shadow. I mean, you guys know if you've been on my channel for a long time. But guys, there is this house that is supposedly haunted by a tall man. A tall man wearing a hat. So of course I'm automatically like, oh my god, this sounds like the Hat Man. So the Hat Man, you know, he is a part of the shadow people. A lot of people say that he's like the leader of the shadow people. He's the creepiest of the shadow people. He stands at the foot of your bed and he's just this 6-foot dark figure, this dark shadow. He wears a hat. He kind of reminds me of the creeper from Jeepers Creepers. That's all I see in my head, or like Abraham Lincoln or something. I guess more the creeper because he's creepy. Abraham Lincoln doesn't freak me out. But the creeper from Jeepers Creepers, heck yes, that freaks me out. So he stands at the foot of your bed and he comes around, you know, when you're going through like emotional times or just like something is going wrong in your life, and he observes you while you are sleeping. So, I mean, that is creepy. Now, this house, this haunted house, they say that they see this man in a hat, this tall man in a hat, but is it the Hat Man? I don't think so. I mean, it's interesting because typically the Hat Man, he doesn't really do much. He just kind of is standing over you while you're sleeping. But these people are seeing this man in a hat and he's doing more than just watching you sleep. So this haunted house is in Missouri and it's a couple who owns it, but instead of selling it, they decided to place it on Airbnb. So crazy people like us, you know, like you and I, we'll stay the night and see if it's haunted and just like have a thrill and just, you know, enjoy and see if we see this tall Hat Man. Oh my god, it's so weird that I'm wearing a hat today. I didn't even plan that. I'm just wearing a hat because my hair looks really bad. But this isn't like the hat that the Hat Man wears. I'm gonna go get a top hat. I mean, since it is Pretty Mean, I mean, this is so Abraham Lincoln, but actually, hold on, I got another hat idea. Okay, this is more like a cowboy hat, but this is, oh, don't mind my roots. This is definitely how I picture the hat for the Hat Man. So this, I look ridiculous, but you know what? It's Halloween, it's Pretty Mean, get used to it. So according to this Missouri couple that live in this haunted house, they say that the first renters to rent this out on Airbnb could not make it through the night. And this is all in quotations. One of the young ladies staying stated that they saw a dark figure on the staircase. And another said she saw a similar dark figure on the porch that is on the second level master bedroom. The young man that booked the home said he smelled a strong odor of sulfur, which I've been told is a demon smell. And yes, they say, like, you know, I've actually smelled that before when I've gone to locations before, and you know, you automatically are just like, okay, like the energy, the vibe, just so many things are off when you smell that. So this group of thrill seekers, they checked into the house at 6 p.m. and left a little after midnight. Oh my god, I need to go to Missouri. So they bought the house in August of 2017 and they didn't move in until October 2017. And you know, when they moved in, everything seemed fine, but around Christmas time is when the activity started to pick up and their dog was acting really weird. And when you have animals that are acting weird, you know something is up. Like if your dog is barking at something and clearly nothing is there, I mean, it's creepy. What do they see? What sees your dog? You know, what is your dog looking at? What is looking at your dog? I think that is really creepy. But when your animals start acting up, that is a huge sign. Like something is going on here. Well, according to this article, the dog started acting up when they first moved in. And it just kept getting worse and worse. But especially around Christmas time, that is when everything was just amplified. The TVs started turning on by themselves at full volume. Now, the creepiest thing that this family has experienced, has encountered, I would definitely say is the daughter sleepwalking, because apparently she does not sleepwalk anywhere else. She can go to her grandmother's house and like spend a weekend and she's totally fine, you know, like she goes to sleep, whatever. When she's back in this house, she starts to sleepwalk. And when she's sleepwalking, she's like making all these like weird movements and, you know, she's acting really odd. And I mean, seeing a sleepwalker freaks me out. I don't know about you guys, that freaks me out, sleepwalkers. Like that just like freaks me out. I don't know, because you just don't know what they're gonna do. Like, are they gonna kill you or something? Honestly, I think I've just watched too many movies, you know? But the parents describe their daughter sleepwalking as if she is possessed, like with her movements and just her overall aura and everything. She just seems like she is possessed. And like I said, she is perfectly fine when she's not in the house. She never sleepwalks, but when she's in the house, she sleepwalks. So that right there is just saying, okay, something is going on in this house. This just gives me chills, but okay. So the husband said that both him and his wife saw a tall man in a suit and a top hat. Maybe I should turn back into my top hat, but you guys get the idea. This is how I picture the hat man, but we are not really talking about the hat man. So hold on. I think I just kind of want it to be the hat man. So back to the top hat, you know, like Abraham Lincoln. They would see this tall man in a top hat at the corner of their eyes. And their daughter, the one that sleepwalks, she remembers when her and her dad came home, she heard a voice say, "Hi." I mean, it probably didn't say hi like that, but still. Just hearing a voice when you know nobody else is in your home and it doesn't sound like anybody in your family, like that, yeah. Okay, so now I'm gonna read the scariest experience that they had. Okay, so this is about the daughter. So you know how she sleepwalks and stuff. So one of the scariest experiences they had, however, reportedly involved their daughter. She was standing outside of her bed, staring out the window. The young girl had reportedly been having nightmares. She was still crying, just sobbing. I could see her shoulders going up and down. Whoo, this just like gave me chills. And I was like, "What's wrong? Are you okay? Are you okay?" She turned around and it scared the life out of me because it went from crying to this, why am I getting freaked out? Like, I don't get freaked out. Okay, I get freaked out, but like not like this. So it went from crying and sobbing. So imagine like, you just like see this, you know, but just pretend I don't have my hat on, but like, and she turned around with this huge smile, almost like the Joker kind of smile. And that was the scariest experience for these poor parents. I mean, what the heck? Why was she sobbing and crying and then turned around? She had this like demonic Joker smile. So, you know, obviously something is going on in this house. And also, this house was featured on the paranormal TV show, The Dead Files. I am a fan of that show. I gotta go back and watch this, but yeah, so that's pretty cool. So according to the father, everyone has experienced something different, from seeing dark figures to be very emotional for no reason, like their daughter, to catching shadow people at the corner of their eyes. And they've apparently had paranormal investigators come in to investigate what is going on in this house. I don't believe it's the hat man though. I really don't. I feel like the hat man is definitely more like sleep paralysis and you see him when you're sleeping, but people are seeing him or this man in the top hat when they are wide awake. They see him at the corner of their eyes, or you know what I mean? Or just like standing on a back porch, or you know, standing at the top of the stairs. But the daughter sleepwalking and acting like she's possessed, chest and then sobbing hysterically and crying and then turning around and having this big Joker-like smile. I think that is so creepy. Like, that just gave me chills. I don't know why that gives me chills. Anyways, my question for you guys is, would you stay at this house overnight? Thank you guys so much for watching. I have a new video that's coming out tomorrow. It's actually all about my It Chapter 2 movie premiere experience, walking the red carpet, seeing the cast. I get into like all the deets. So thank you guys so much for watching. Hashtag team Brittany44, hashtag Baritha friends. Hey, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.